Hello, in this video I'm going to show you the results from a CFD run I performed on the Onera M6 wing. The Onera M6 is a classic validation case for CFD, and has been included in over 130 papers. The beauty of this case is that it allows you to study complex transonic flow phenomenon with a relatively simple geometry. The simplicity of the geometry streamlines the whole process. For example, meshing is relatively simple, but lessons learned can be applied to more complex cases. I'm interested in performing simulations of NASA's CRM models. One of these, the high-speed CRM, provides data for the evaluation of aerodynamics of modern airliners and crews. Further down the road, I am interested in multipoint adjoint optimization methods on the high-speed CRM. Before that, we must test the individual building blocks we will eventually need by performing simpler test cases. In this video, we will just focus on the simplest transonic case. For instance, we will compare the results to published CFD and experimental CP, or coefficient of pressure, surface data, and visually with the published shock formations. I hope you find the content presented in this video to be as informative and exciting as I did making it. Now for the simulation. Because I know many of you don't have access to Pointwise, I'm just going to play through a sped up version of meshing and explain some of the basic things I am doing, such as mesh sizing and my general strategy. My general approach to meshing wings is to size the layers parallel to the leading edge to be roughly 0.1% chord length and 1% chord at the trailing edge. My spanwise spacing is determined by the expected physics of the flow. I'm keeping it fairly fine here because this is a transonic case and I'm expecting spanwise gradients. Something you'll see me do here is adjust the mesh spacing at domain junctions to be roughly equal. This will ensure that your area ratio will stay relatively small. I shoot for around a max of 8 for quads and 3 to 4 for tries. Controlling your area ratio will ensure that adjacent cells are similar in size, which means your meshing solver should have an easier time creating inflation layers. Another thing you can see me add are sources. These are features in Pointwise which allow you to control the local cell size without affecting your surface mesh spacing. I am adding two cylinders, one in the region I am expecting shock waves, and one where the wingtip vortex will form. I am oversizing these on purpose. And once the surface meshes are satisfactory, I diagonalize them. This splits all of the quads into tries. I do this because Pointwise inflates pyramids off of quads. The high aspect ratio cells near the leading and trailing edges would thus fail due to having a very high included angle. Diagonalizing avoids this issue. To compute my inflation layer spacing, I used online air properties calculators and a Y plus layer calculator, all of which will be linked below. It may seem that I do an excessive number of inflation layers, but this approach lets the layers grow until their volumes match those of the isotropic cells, thus giving a smooth cell transition ratio. Once again, this may be a bit overkill, but I am not computationally limited, and this approach has worked well in the past. And finally, you can see me check various mesh properties and exporting. Once again, I'm going to gloss over this because it will change depending on your meshing and CFD software. As mentioned in the introduction, the purpose of this video is to compare against validated data. Because of this, I only tested at one condition, Mach 0.84, alpha 3.06 degrees. The case was run in Fun3D on 40 cores and took 7 minutes of wall time to converge. The convergence data can be seen here. The stopping criteria was met at 476 iterations. Here you can see a spanwise sweep of CP. Please note the formation of the normal shock, which via inspection appears to match the published results well. Here is a 3D scatter plot. The X and Y axes represent the X and Y positions, and the Z axis represents CP. The data in blue comes from my runs, and the data in magenta is the published data. This next plot is of the results of the experiment and published data. The XYZ axes are the spatial locations of the points, and CP is represented via the color data. Overall, the results from my computations match very well with the published data in terms of the magnitudes and shape of pressure contours. It appears that our methods were able to capture the shock for the transonic flow relatively accurately. For the next steps, I will perform a similar analysis on the NASA high-speed CRM. This case contains a wing and body of a generic airliner and is the natural progression after the Onera M6. That case will allow us to validate our methods on more complex interfering flows with bigger datasets. And after that, we will begin to look into simple single-point adjoint optimization cases. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video and learned something from it, please like, share, and subscribe. Goodbye.